You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we look at Azure Machine Learning Service and all of the awesome developer tools that help us be productive with AI in the cloud. See you then. Hello, welcome to this episode of the AI Show, where we're going to look at Azure Machine Learning Service, but specifically the tooling behind it. I have a special guest today. Chris, how are you doing, buddy?
I'm doing awesome. Thanks, Seth, for having me.
Why don't you introduce yourself?
Absolutely. So I'm a program manager in Azure AI team focused on developer tooling. And specifically today, we're going to talk about Visual Studio Code tools for AI and how you can do AI too, locally and in the cloud.
Fantastic. So let's start out with what's Azure Machine Learning Service. We'll do like a quick overview and then we'll look at the tooling that's available.
Sure.
All right, let's do it.
Absolutely. So Azure Machine Learning is a service that runs in Azure to keep track of all of your machine learning experiments, your data, your compute targets, your models, and your deployed services that use those models like an intelligent function that you can call via a REST API and get back a result from your trained model.
Awesome.
Now, you can train those models anywhere and deploy them in Azure using Docker containers that run on Kubernetes service so that it's highly load balanced and super easy to use and super performant.
So if you're a data scientist, you need to understand all this Docker container Kubernetes stuff, because I have a hard time with Kubernetes and Docker sometimes. So you have to know what that is in order to make this work?
Absolutely not. I'm actually going to show you how using Visual Studio Code tools for AI, you can generate a new Azure Kubernetes cluster with just right-clicking something, and you can even generate your Docker image that has your model and deploy it and get a REST API, again, just right-clicking, almost no code, except for just your Python code that runs your model, which you would run anywhere in any Jupyter notebook or in Visual Studio Code.
Fantastic. So let's get into the actual service. What are we looking at right here?
Sure, absolutely. So this is the Azure Portal. And in the Azure Portal, then you can see we've got a bunch of experiments. You can see compute targets, models, images. These are Docker images. And deployments. So those are your actual running services. On the right, you can see I run a couple of experiments within the context of this workspace. And as we scroll down, you can see that there's multiple different runs for the same experiment, because I always try the same thing over and over to try and get a little bit better, a little bit faster, a little bit better quality results. And so quickly and easily, you can see all the different experiments that I run, and you can see kind of an overview of the duration. But if you drill into any given one of these, then you can also see the different quality metrics that I logged during that experiment.
Fantastic. So let me see if I understand this. Like, this whole thing I'm seeing is called Machine Learning Service Workspace. Like, what is a workspace? How should I think about it?
You should think about it as just a big container or a box of stuff. And inside that box of stuff, then I've got different experiments. Mm-hmm. I've got my models that I can keep track of where they are. Mm-hmm. I've got different compute targets. So if I've got, instead of having just a bunch of virtual machines scattered around Azure and all the data scientists on my team not knowing where to find them, for example.
I see.
Then we can put all these different things inside a workspace. And in that workspace, then we can find them and share them and get access to them. Just by granting access to the workspace, then I get access to all the different compute targets. So I can not just find them, but also actually use them.
I see.
I don't have to go and grant permissions to all the individual things.
And that's awesome, because like generally, like I'm like my trail of sadness when doing AI is like I'm basically changing code over and over again. And I can't see like, what did I do like 3 times ago? So this allows you to remember like how you went about actually solving an AI problem.
That's absolutely right, and where you did it. And so if somebody wanted to reproduce it using the same set of machines, then they can absolutely find those in the workspace as well.
Fantastic. So this is a super good overview of Azure Machine Learning Service. But as a developer, usually data scientists are going to be using the things that they like to use. How do we support them in that?
Sure. So I personally don't like to use the Azure Portal for actually writing code. That kind of makes no sense to me as mm-hmm. a developer. I prefer to use Visual Studio Code. Mm-hmm. And so let me show you how with Visual Studio Code Tools for AI extension that's available in Visual Studio Code, not only can I see all my different code, so like I've got a Python script here to train a machine learning model, mm-hmm. but if I click the Azure Activity Bar, then we can see I've got this Azure Machine Learning view here as well. And notice this same Azure Machine Learning workspace is available within the subscription. Now I can filter to all the different Azure subscriptions that I have, so I don't have to see all of them all at once in the VS Code view, because that just clutters things
right,
up,
of course.
Right? And then within that workspace, then those same experiments that I was looking at earlier, I can see them here. Now this folder of code that I have in VS Code, I need to attach it to the folder to an experiment. So I say, this code I'm working on my local machine, I'm going to attach it to this experiment in Azure Machine Learning.
And that's where you get all those cool metrics that we saw before. So
right.
if I'm a data scientist, I already have my own, let's just say, MNIST for sake of arguments, because it's the easiest one for everyone to understand. I already wrote my own code. Do I need to change anything to make it work inside of Azure Machine Learning Service?
You don't need to change a whole lot. What you do need to do is you need to look at, you see, define the run.getContext. This is an Azure Machine Learning run. So every time I run my experiment, it's a new run.
I see.
And so then I'm just going to get a handle to the run if I'm running in the context of Azure Machine Learning. And if so, then I can use the run.log method, for example, to log the metrics that I care about.
I see. So if you want the cool visualizations, you can log. But if you don't log it, it'll still run in the cloud as is.
Or it can even run locally and just log all the metrics to the cloud.
I see.
As I'm stepping through debugging my code on my local machine, then I can still just keep track of my experiment using Azure Machine Learning.
Oh, that's pretty cool. So look, as a data scientist, usually what I do is I don't know what I'm doing, and then I usually pull up a notebook, try some things out. Okay, this works. I cut and paste the code into something like this. How are you going to support me with Jupyter Notebooks?
Sure, absolutely. So a lot of data scientists get started early in their process using Jupyter Notebooks, and I'm no exception. Now, we've added support in Visual Studio Code for Jupyter Notebooks, such that you can use the Azure Machine Learning Python SDK to keep track of your experiment from code, if you'd like to, or use any other Python libraries inside Jupyter Notebooks as well. And now this is not just a viewer of the notebook. You can actually step through and execute all the individual commands, just like you normally would.
So it's running the Jupyter Notebook service, and you're running it just like I would any other time, except it's in the context of Visual Studio Code.
That's right, which is great for me, because personally, once I step through and kind of get an idea as to whether an experiment is really going to work or not, then I want to take the code out of the Jupyter Notebook and usually put it into individual Python files so I can check them into source control, share them, version them, debug, refactor. And so working on both the notebook and the code all in VS Code really helps me be super productive.
Awesome. So let's take a look at the Azure tab again to see
Absolutely.
What's available. So when I'm looking at this team workspace, everything that everyone on the team has done, you'll be able to see like from their experiments, from what they're computing, et cetera.
Yep, that's right. And so you can even see this compute node. So we talked about what an experiment is. The compute node, I can easily create more powerful compute context in Azure if I would like to. So let me show you quickly. We can create the compute. We could say create an Azure Kubernetes service if we wanted to deploy my models to use in production. Or if I wanted to create a batch AI cluster, for example. I think, Seth, you probably deserve a GPU cluster of your own. So I'm just going to go ahead and create Seth's GPU cluster.
Of course.
And I'm going to give it a name. Now, I've got a bunch of different sizes of virtual machines, and I honestly can never keep track of exactly what the name is. Mm-hmm. So I'm just going to go ahead and search for something with a GPU in here. And I find, the V3 sounds pretty good. It's got a GPU of V100 and it has four of them. Do you think that would meet your need?
I feel like I need some of those.
Yeah,
yes.
Okay, great. So let's go ahead and create that. Now I've got this config file. You see, one of the interesting things about the Batch AI service is that it actually can automatically scale to the certain number of nodes. These are the number of virtual machines in the cluster. And so by default, you can have zero machines, which means that when no jobs are running, the cluster actually doesn't exist.
So I'm not going to be charged for this stuff. That's awesome.
Right. But then as you submit jobs, then it'll create the virtual machine, it'll put your Docker container there, it'll run it, and that's awesome. And you can set some controls on here, like never have more than four virtual machines at a time, for example. And we selected the GPU of four V100s, mm-hmm. right? So if we had four virtual machines with four V100s each, you actually would have up to 16 GPUs in this cluster, or you could have, you know, if I really liked you, I could get you a whole lot.
Wow.
I don't like you that much.
That's a lot of digits we're going to be recognizing in the cloud. I'm pretty excited.
Absolutely. So we can go ahead and click finish and create the machine, the cluster. Now, I already have one here for the purpose of the show today. Now, within the context of a particular compute context, mm-hmm. you need to have what we call a run configuration file. And the run configuration file enables repeating an experiment over and over, if you'd like, in a consistent way. And so that says, like, what script do you want to run as your primary script? What parameters do you want to run? Mm-hmm. And that sort of thing. So you can just simply right-click, you can create your run configuration file, uh-huh. and you can again see that down here, we have multiple run configuration files.
Okay, so let me see if I understand this, because this went kind of fast. So when you're looking at your local folder that now you've attached to an experiment, there are run configurations that allow you to submit jobs to the GPU cluster.
That's right.
And I'm seeing two other ones there, Docker and local. Are those just run configurations that exist by default?
That's right. So as soon as I attach my folder to the experiment, mm-hmm. then VS Code will automatically create these two run configurations for you and set up all of the default settings automatically.
All right, so let's see if I can summarize what we've learned. So the first thing is we looked at the Azure portal and what a Azure Machine Learning Service workspace was. It's a configuration where you can have a bunch of people collaborating and have a bunch of assets. It's like your AI toolbox for machine learning.
That's right.
The second thing we looked at is Visual Studio Code tools for AI that lets you run notebooks within the context that you know and you love. You can run Azure Notebooks, I keep saying Azure Notebooks because we have an Azure version of Jupyter Notebooks.
They're so easy to use in Azure Notebooks. They've become synonymous for you.
So Jupyter Notebooks, you can run it in there and then test your code. Then you can move it into regular Python files that you tend to run, and you can submit them into the team workspace experimentation service by targeting different compute clusters, or where the run configs will tell you how you want to submit them.
Or you can even just run them on your local machine and log the metrics to Azure as well.
Awesome.
So you can experiment quickly, step through, and debug on your local machine. Make it super productive in Visual Studio Code.
So this is awesome. I feel like I want to still like go through an actual example of it, but I feel like this is a super good overview of what AI developers can do on Azure and Visual Studio Code.
Yeah, absolutely.
Well, thanks so much for spending some time with us. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care. Thank you.